Good evening and welcome to Studio Wrestling. Are you here for a good time? Can you hear back there? Okay. I'm Bill Cardille, Chili Billy, and we had Studio Wrestling live at Channel 11 for close to 20 years, and also Chiller Theater for 20 years. I want to thank you. First of all, we have a crowd back here coming up. It's a little different this year. You get your pictures, buy your pictures, and then you come up and get an autograph. We have a lot of wrestlers here for you. And before I introduce our guest stars behind me, you can get autograph Mahoney Durso. And they have their pictures right down there. Those are free. But with the stars, these pictures here, you buy those and then you come up here. However, I'd like you to meet as we interview Steele.
Hey! Nice! How you doing? We're going to have fun today.
Absolutely. You know, George is living in Florida, so he had to come up yesterday and he says glad to be back here in Pittsburgh, and also nice to see George. I tell you, you haven't changed much at all, really. You look the same.
When you start off ugly, it's easy to stay that way.
He'll be with me next week. He's going to stick around, and he's going to be at the Monster Bash up in Butler. Are you going to be there whole weekend?
Yes, I am.
Oh boy. They show the movies and all that, and the Hollywood stars come in at Days In. I do that every year, and it's a great show with Ron Adams. But George, it's a pleasure to see you, and I can't say enough nice things about you. Good seeing you, buddy. Now, over here, Greg, the Hammer Valentine. I remember, he looks more like his dad now than ever, I tell you. Remember Johnny Valentine? There's a picture right here. When you come up on stage, take a look at that. Johnny Valentine, Texas heavyweight champion. Oh man, I tell you, that's a nice one. Anyway, Greg, I'll give you the microphone. Say hello to our friend.
Well, it's good to be back in good old Pittsburgh. I remember Channel 11 with my partner, Donnie Fargo, and I go, where is this TV station at anyway? We just kept going up a hill, and I remember one time we were going down the hill, and it was all ice. So it was a lot of scary moments there.
I know it. I remember Crush Lozowski saying, on the suicide by jumping out a basement window. Because he walked up the hill from downtown almost every time he was on Studio Wrestling, and Pike Trainer, God rest his soul. I just got a book on Pike Trainer, incidentally. It's good, and it's out, and the Penn State graduate, a professor up there, and a fellow from Boston wrote it about Pike Trainer, and outstanding story. It's really nice. But Greg, it's good seeing you.
One of my first main event matches, and I wasn't Greg Valentine then, I was Johnny Fargo, and Donnie Fargo was the Fargo brothers against these two guys right here, Dominic, DeNucci, and Bruno.
How did it go?
I don't remember, I was so nervous.
But no wrestling today, okay? Now, a friend for many years. You know, I've been around athletes that did all the play-by-play on WQED and all the events, basketball, football, covering all the professional sports. I did a lot of that for a long time. But I'll tell you, and I've said it on the air, the best people in professional sports, when they tell you they're your friend and they shake your hand, they mean it. And I'm talking not only like Bruno Sammartino and the fellows that are up here and also over there, but Crush Lozowski. I have to tell you a story. One time, I don't know if Bruno, maybe you'll remember, a long time ago, I had a teenage dance show when I first came to Pittsburgh, and I went to Grove City in a big snowstorm, and it was at Grove City College, and I'm from Sharon, Pennsylvania, But I was on national TV on NBC covering the storm, and then I had to do wrestling, and then I went to Grove City. I was lucky to make it. Anyway, the two promoters that did it, they didn't pay me. Of all the shows I've ever done, those two, they pocketed the money themselves. But I didn't care. I go home, I go to Sharon, stay overnight. So I sent them a bill and all that. For 3 months, I never collected. So I was telling Crusher Lazowski, he was going to Grove City this Saturday night, one Saturday night, and he was going to go into the ring. And I said, you know what? Crusher, I said, there's a guy up there. I won't say what kind of a car dealership he was, and I won't give you his name. I did at the time. And the Better Business Bureau got involved. But anyway, I said, he didn't pay me. He took in about $3,000. I think I was getting $100 at the most. He says, you want me to collect it? I said, would you? He said, yeah. If he doesn't pay, I'll throw him through his window. And I said, well, that sounds pretty good to me. I don't know if you remember. Bruno overheard us. And he came over, he says, Bill, you better not tell him to do that. He will throw him through the window. So I went over. I had to convince him not to do it. He didn't, and I never collected. Anyway, that's the story. And here's another nice guy, Dominic DeNucci. Come on, DeNucci, stand up there. How's the world treating you?
Wonderful, good old man. I'm doing good. And I can't say all of the people in Greensburg, because I come here a few times, but I can't say Pennsylvania or Pittsburgh, because I've been here 40 years. 40. And last few months ago, matter of fact, July the 1st, is going to be 40 years I've been married to the same lady.
How about that, 40 years? Nice lady, too.
And you know what, I live out in the Granbury, so I'm close everywhere. And I like Pennsylvania, and I like Pittsburgh.
We like you, and it's nice knowing you all these years. You're great. You're a credit to the profession. Now I'm just going to give the microphone to Bruno Sammartino. Bruno, stand up. We have some pictures to sign, but we were here last year. We had a great crowd and a nice turnout, and I know that Bruno wants to thank you.
Yes, absolutely want to thank you. We had a wonderful time last year. It's great to be back this year to see all you folks. And I think that you guys have been standing there pretty long, and I think you better get your show on the road, because I know standing for so long, it gets a little achy on the back and the knees and everything. So great to be here. Nice to see everybody. And we're ready to start.
Hey, Bobby, stand up and give a wave. He's become a cowboy. Better than a cowgirl, though. Hi, cowboy. Hurricane Hunt. And Mahoney Durso. Frank Durso. Stand up, turn around. There's my man. All right, Frankie. And then Jumping Johnny DeFazio has had quite a career. Born and raised in Pittsburgh. Well loved by everybody. Now, those of you that come up, I have free pictures here. Also, I have free flyers. I'm going to the Panama Canal on my radio show. We have about 40 people already signed up for 2 weeks. And it's going to be the last week in October, the first week in November. And we also have only about 10 of these. My pictures are free. I'll sign a picture for you. This here is from a telelog put out by Channel 11 and NBC. For June 1962, and my buddy, where's John? Anyway, John Buryak, our website, Schiller Theater Memory.